begin tonight's program with the Pledge of Allegiance led by two of our graduates. Would Jasmine Davis and Michael Fisher Jr. please join us on stage? Everybody please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Could I ask that everybody please remain standing and join me for a moment of silence to acknowledge the empty seat we have tonight in our graduating class for Jonathan Hoffman. Thank you. Welcome, Sue Servalek, Board of Education, faculty, family, friends, and alumni to Farmington Central High School Class of 2012 graduation ceremony. To officially start our program tonight, I need to ask the seniors for a little help. Seniors, would you please help me recognize your teachers for their help and getting you here tonight? Would the staff from Farmington Central please stand? Thank you. Now, seniors, I need you to stand. I need you to stand. Wait. Turn around and join me in another round of applause for your family members. Without their unconditional love and support, we wouldn't be here tonight celebrating. Okay, seniors, I think you think you're done, but there's one more group that I need you to join me in thanking, and that is our superintendent, Sue Servalek, and our wonderful school board for believing in Central and believing in you. Special thanks also go out to my secretary, Sandy Welling, for all the help and support she has given me through this year and for her work on this program. I also had the help of two wonderful volunteers, Fran Florence and Jackie Brachel, who gave me their time and energy for tonight's ceremony. Now, let me share a little background about our graduates. We have 47 seniors graduating in the class of 2012. Of those 47 seniors, there are 18 girls and 29 boys. Our former students of Farmington High, 11 are former students of North Farmington High, and 7 are former students of Harrison. Some of them are entering the workforce, Others will be serving our country in the armed forces. And others will be heading off to college. After tonight, though, these seniors will be graduates of Farmington Central High School and proud Cougars. It gives me great pleasure to introduce our superintendent, Sue Servalek.
Thank you, Pat. Good evening, everyone. It's really my pleasure to be able to welcome you officially on behalf of the school district and our Board of Education, our faculty, and many people that make this school system such a wonderful place. It is, I'm delighted to be able to recognize the wonderful students from Farmington Central, the tremendous faculty you have, and to wish you all congratulations. I am joined on stage from some very important people that I would like to recognize. I'm going to ask these incredibly dedicated members of our Board of Education and staff to please stand when I call their names. So please hold your applause until the end. Sheila Clay, President of our Board of Education. Karen Bolson, Vice President. Priscilla Briette, Secretary. Frank Reed, Treasurer. Dr. Murray Kahn, Trustee. And in the back, although he can't be seen, is Mr. Mark Wilson, Executive Director for Instructional Services. All of these people support you, support our students, support Central in its success. So please join me in giving them a big round of applause. Tonight we celebrate you, the 47 men and women who have completed the requirements of a Farmington Public Schools high school diploma and are graduating as the class of 2012 from Farmington Central High School. To the graduates, while there's no doubt that you are graduating at a time of great challenge and uncertainty in our state and in our nation, there are still hopeful signs that our state and national economies are improving. We know the unemployment rate is dropping, and in Michigan, especially, and there is job growth that has outpaced the national average. These are all hopeful signs that when you are ready to enter the workforce, whether immediately upon your graduation or following college, technical school, or the military, there is even a greater likelihood that there will be career opportunities right here in your home state. Something I'm sure your parents would be very glad to see. We also know, though, that there are still many challenges that will require your leadership, your creativity, and your problem solving as our next generation of leaders. Whether it's the fundamental transformation from reliance on a 20th century manufacturing economy to a 21st century knowledge-based global economy, or the many other challenges that are out there, such as climate change, universal access to quality health care, or access to high quality public education for all children, just to name a few, it is your generation that will have the opportunity to solve many of these most pressing challenges. I hope, graduates, that these challenges will not cause you to lose faith in your country and in your state and in your nation and disengage from the issues. Because now, more than ever, we really need you. We need you, our future leaders, to get involved and be inspired to make a difference. While we know there are challenges and that they are great, and it would probably be a lot easier to shrug off the mantle of responsibility and leadership, I really hope that you don't. Indeed, our democratic system needs you, needs your voices, and needs your leadership now more than ever. I am very optimistic that this graduating class will accept that mantle of responsibility and leadership and will step up to get involved in solving our our state and nation's most pressing challenges. Everything in your schooling, while at Farmington Central and in the Farmington Public Schools, points to this. First, you are to be congratulated for completing one of the most rigorous curriculums in this state and in the country. Yes, give them a round of applause. This was not an easy task. You can also be very proud to know that you have acquired the 21st century knowledge and skills of a Farmington Public School graduate. For example, your experiences at Farmington Central have helped you to become a global citizen, demonstrating civic responsibilities of integrity, honesty, fairness, justice, and respect for all. You've also been taught to be a thoughtful problem solver and resourceful, one who thinks critically and creatively to explore and evaluate solutions. And as one of the great strengths of our school district is the diversity of many cultures, you have acquired cultural competencies that will enable you to live, work, and learn with people from all backgrounds and walks of life around the world. By achieving all of the characteristics of the learner profile, which also include being knowledgeable, a good communicator, interdependent team member, and a healthy and lifelong learner, you have the skills and the fortitude to continue your education and life and make a positive difference in our state, our nation, and even our world. There are many ways for you to make an impact, both big and small. First and foremost, I hope you register to vote if you haven't already, because voting in your first state and national elections are very important first steps. Beyond this fundamental democratic responsibility, however, get involved in something that really matters to you. Listen to your inner voice. What are you passionate about? Really get involved in something you care about. Make connections with people who are different from yourself and challenge yourself to learn something new that pushes your thinking beyond your comfort zone. These are just a few examples of how you can make a difference in your community, in your state, in your country, and yes, even in your world. By finding your passion, pursuing your dreams for a better future, and effectuating the change you want to see in the world. The late Steve Jobs said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't let the noise of other opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and your intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary." In closing, Farmington Central High School Class of 2012, have courage and find a path to make your dreams real, as they will become the opportunities for change. It's that courage to try new things and to not give up that has brought you here today, and that determination and courage will help you build your future and realize your dreams. Best wishes and congratulations to the Farmington Central High School Class of 2012.
Now, if I could ask the school board to have a seat in the front row, we're going to be showing a DVD. And for the families out there, we'd like to give you a short glimpse of what life was like this year at Farmington Central, thanks to our teacher, Mrs. Murphy.
from Senegal, West Africa, to St. Louis, Missouri. Thanks to Catherine Dunham for giving my pops his glory. He came down with his crown and a dream to change the world.
Thank you. See, we at Central, we make do, whatever. We have to. Thank you, Mrs. Murphy. That was a great video. I hope all of you enjoyed it as much as the kids did their time there. All right, seniors, I want you to think back over your last 12, 13, or even 14 years of school. I want you to think about what you have learned along the way. You learned to ride bikes. You learned to drive cars. You made friends, made a few enemies. You found your first love, and many of you experienced the agony of your first love lost. A lot has happened. As you have grown up, some of life's experience were great for some of you and not so great for others. At times, life might have felt like you were on a curvy, crazy path. Parents have lost jobs. Families have lost homes. Some of us have lost family members. And we even lost a fellow cougar. Day after day, the news is full of stories about the economy, budget cuts, and sadness. And yet, there is something to smile about. The best part is, the sun always comes up the next morning, giving us a new dawn, a new chance, a new day. You sitting here right now, this is your new day. Seniors, on behalf of the staff at Farmington Central High School, I want you to know how proud we are of all of you. You have been a memorable group of seniors. And now that we have given you the tools for your future, it is time for you to go and do something with it. Show your Cougar pride by really being part of the future. And finally, to the class of 2012, after you leave Central High today, there will be no more plus classes, no more bathroom passes or evacuation drills, no more MME ACT test, intercom announcements, or snacks to purchase in Ms. Cadwell School store. There will be no more Ms. Champagne and Ms. Primo yelling in the commons for you to get to class. No more papers to write for Mrs. Alusi or Mrs. Murphy. Not one more math warm-up with Miss Ely or Mrs. Olson. No more recycling with Miss Haas or paper mache with Miss Belozic. There will be no more chicken ring lunches from Mr. Kent. There will be no more lunch detentions or free food from Mrs. Karras. Remember the stories that took place over the past year or years at Central. Like the first day you started with us, some of you thought to yourself, oh, I so don't belong here. In fact, some of you told me, I hated Central. But in time, you learned to like us. In fact, some of you learned to love us. We became a family. Remember the plus class competition, Spirit Week, Minute to Win It, the pancake breakfast that the teachers cooked, and Operation Success. But more importantly, remember that the stories would not be possible without the people in your lives, your friends, your family, your teachers. The list goes on and on. These stories create the memories that will last a lifetime. Take a moment to look around and see all the people who have meant so much to you. I hope the memory lasts forever. Seniors, the time you spent at Central, I witnessed you grow as students, as people, and you became young adults. You made wonderful decisions and made a number of mistakes during your time here, as I did, your principal. You made us angry, you made us laugh, but at the end of the day, we were always smiling because of you and your endurance. Today, the Farmington Central chapter of your life story ends, but there are many more chapters ahead. Remember to continue to have stories on which your memories will be based. Remember to always have fun, and remember to laugh. My story ends today for the class of 2012, but I know in my heart that the story for all of you has truly just begun. As Oprah Winfrey has said, create the highest, grandest vision possible for your life, because you become what you believe. Always believe that you will ultimately succeed at whatever you do, and never forget the value of persistence, discipline, and determination you demonstrated at Central to get you here today. Good luck. Thank you all for the time you spent at Central. Know that we will miss you, and I know you will continue to shine in the years ahead. Congratulations. At this time, I would like to introduce the school board president, Sheila Clay, who will also say a few words.
I sat and watched the video, and there were some words that moved me enough that I wanted to write them down that I'm assuming these describe this class. You said, we are family, we are a team. You called yourself Team Profit. Resilience is brilliance. Another chance, another choice, another chance. I'm gonna talk about that one again in a minute. And I heard the words of the song that said, on the edge of glory. All of these describe the class of 2012. All of these words describe your class. You've come now to a phase of your life that you're walking through a door, that you're getting ready to take more control over really what happens to you from this point forward. Your parents are in the uncomfortable position right now, in the uncomfortable phase of their life. They have to set you free. And they have to pray that everything that they tried to teach you, all the lessons they tried to teach you, the words of wisdom they had you listen to, that you heard them. And if you didn't think they had relevance then, believe me, they're gonna have relevance very soon in your life. I want to tell you that the four things that I told all the other graduating classes, four life skills that I hope that you take with you. Some of them have a deeper meaning for me as I sit here and look out at you. One is to see your vision, believe your vision, and stand by your vision. You will figure out who you are. Because believe me, you may think you know now, you're still growing. You're gonna figure out who you are and what you stand for. Figure that out. Because if you don't figure out what you stand for, you will fall for anything. Find out what you're passionate about. Create that vision, and regardless of what somebody may come and make you try to doubt your vision, and sometimes it's not what people say, it's what they don't say that can make you do that. Don't ever give up on your dreams, because once you do that, you've given up on you. And don't ever, ever give up on you.
Number two is to be true to who you are. E.E. Cummings says it takes a lot of courage to grow up and be who you are. Don't play being anybody else. There's nothing wrong with who I'm looking at right now in these red and white gowns. Trust yourself, believe in yourself, and if people don't accept who you are, that's not your loss, it's theirs. They will learn to accept who you are, and if they don't, move on. I told the other class that I remember when I was in high school, I won't talk about how long ago that was, but I will say that I'm a graduate. I forgot to tell the other classes, I'm a graduate of Cass Tech High School, and I will tell you when I graduated. 1971, it's a long time ago. But I remember in high school, even then, I had friends who tried to encourage me to drink. I never liked or developed the taste for alcohol. I don't drink even to this day. It just doesn't taste good. It's not that something's wrong, it just doesn't taste good to me. My friends would say, oh, come on, Sheila, but I don't like to drink. They finally accepted who I was, and they accepted my choices, and they accepted me. I didn't lose a friend, I wasn't ostracized. Everybody learned to accept that choice I made for me, and they're gonna do the same thing for you. Don't ever compromise who you are. Number three, surround yourself with the right people and be the right person. I know you've heard your parents over and over. I say it to my son now. Hang out, you know, make sure you're with the right people. Oprah Winfrey says, associate yourself with somebody who's gonna make, who's gonna take you up higher. It's gonna take you higher. You may find a mentor, whether it be in the service, because I heard some of you are going to the service, whether it be on a job or whether it's in college, but find a mentor who's on the road that you believe that you wanna get on. And tie your tail to that person. The fourth one is about you working hard. The only place, if I get it right, I'm gonna mess up. The only place that success comes before work is in the dictionary. That's it. You're not gonna find it anyplace else. You're gonna have to work hard. Are you gonna be tested? Absolutely. You might even fail, but the biggest failure is you don't pick yourself up again and try again. That's the biggest failure. You are a testament. You've already been tested. You have already been tested. You know you've already been tested, but you're sitting here with these red and white gowns on. You overcame and you won the test. You won the test. And when you get tested again, pick yourself up and keep moving forward. Don't ever stop. You must keep moving forward. When I came on the board, and I didn't really know what I was really getting myself into. When I came on the board, the person I replaced, his name is Pam Christian. And Pam gave me a book that I read to the other classes, and I'm gonna read it to you. It's called Life's Journey. And I want you to listen really carefully to the words. As you journey through life, choose your destinations well, but don't hurry there. You'll arrive soon enough. Wander the back roads, sharing your unique gifts with those who cross your path. Seek out those in need and lend them a hand. Such experiences are riches for the soul. And if upon arrival, you find that your destination is not exactly as you dreamed, don't be disappointed. Know that the true worth of your travels lies not in where you come to be at the journey's end, but in the lives you touch along the way and the person you became on the way. Class of 2012, congratulations. And now the words you've been waiting all this time to hear. On behalf of the Board of Education and the Farmington Public School District, by the power vested in me, I declare that the Farmington Central High School class of 2012 is now officially graduating.
Thank you, Sheila. Can I have the first row of graduates? Please line up. Ms. Primo and Ms. Champagne. All right, are we ready? It's my honor to start the list of graduates. Dorian Allen Allinger. Carly Chantel Allman. Marcellos Butler. Henry Caleb III. Jennifer Elise Carpenter. Jasmine Krista Davis. Arnisa Dickey. Christina Dijonai. Mariah Louisa Escamilla. Carlo Etta. Michael Allen Fisher. Helen Nicole Ford. Michael David Kenneth Percasi. We need the next row. Antonio Cabrini Jr. Jalen Christine Harrell. Joy Alicia Hill. Kayla Mitchell. Christopher O'Brien Morgan. Zachary Patrick Murphy. Yasmin Nadim. Ryan Elliott Odian. Caitlin Grace Castle. Michael Palmer. Next row, please. Deanna Lynn Parker. Alexandra Pearson. Anthony A.D. Fitzinerat. Curtis Raymond. Chelsea Hope Shady. Devin Allen Shamu. Damo Terrell Smith. Natasha Latrice Smith. Johnny L. Williams III. Okay, there is one last diploma that I need to award tonight, and that's to Jonathan Hoffman. Accepting the diploma on behalf of the Hoffman family is Scott Allen and Max Deshevsky. On behalf of the Hoffman family, Max is going to say a few words.
Hello, my name is Max Deshevsky. I was a very good friend of Jonathan Hoffman. Because Mr. Hoffman and his family could not be present tonight due to a pressing family situation, he asked that I read the following on his behalf. I'm very honored to be here. I know my son would have been proud also. He would have every right to be. In recent days, those who in the media have suggested that Farmington Central is an alternative school for troubled teens are misguided and small-minded. In his short tenure here, it is apparent to me that John blossomed and that he was well along his personal journey. Trouble has a way of sometimes finding us. This I know. How we handle it and how we make of it is paramount. The many tributes to my son, including this one, have been more than touching. Thank you. Go forward, have fun, be there for each other, and from time to time, remember those left behind. And whenever you remember my son, my Jonathan, be filled with peace and inspiration like I am, whenever his beautiful face crosses my mind. John was an angel. Godspeed, Michael Hoffman and family.
Thank you, Max. Now I would like to introduce our first graduate speaker, Helen Ford.
Hello, my name is Helen Ford. First off, I would like to welcome all the parents, staff of Farmington Central, the school board, and the class of 2012 to one of the best days of our lives. When I first attended Farmington High School in the year of 2010, as a senior, I was far away from achieving all of my credits, so I needed to graduate. I had hopes about my future and myself. So with that, I did everything I could do to make it through the year and walk across the stage. But it ended up that way. I missed a lot of school due to illness. Knowing I was not letting myself down, but my family and teachers down, I became stressed. With all my high school life, I was fighting against my own demons. I fell in a deep hole that I couldn't get out of. Deep down, I wanted to know everyone that could do it. Sadly, my illness took its toll. I had to wait till next year to take the walk across the stage. This year, I came to school knowing this is the year I had to fight my own doubt. Voices tell me I can't do it and I'll never be a success in my life. Even though I wasn't feeling my best, I went to school and completed all the assignments I was given. I was finally becoming proud of myself. After all these years in high school, I was truly happy and stress-free. At this point, I became the person I wanted to be, successful and hopeful for the future. One of the biggest accomplishments was in my physics class when I found out I had the highest test score in the whole class. I always enjoyed science all through my school years, but when I missed school, it became stressful. This year, I really got to enjoy all the science classes I got to take. Farmington Central created a lot of memories. From Spirit Week, Minute to Win It, and our Senior versus Undergrad game, we created new friends and shared laughs. When we did Minute to Win It, my plus class put our game faces on and got ready to win it. Ms. Haas was determined for us to finally win a plus tournament. We practiced for 2 weeks trying to perfect our strategies. In the end, we ended up losing, but nonetheless, we had a great time. The senior versus undergrad softball game was also a great memory. The seniors had the lead for the first few innings. Towards the end, it was a close game. of 16 to 15. Two strikes for the undergrads, and then he was out. The seniors had won the game. I even gave the team 3 runs. I will always remember these memories and think back of all the friends I have made throughout the 2 years I was here. Fellow classmates, I know you can conquer anything you set your mind to. Together we have been through the good, the bad, and sadly even the tragic. Seeing all of you get through it, I know you can overcome what gets thrown at you. For each and every one of you are strong. Always before God and the world, the strong has the right to carry through what he wills. Never give up. The world's a tough place. Be strong, and you will go as far as you would like. The only person stopping you is you. At this time, I would like to thank all the people that made this day come true. My mother, for never giving up on me and telling me I could do whatever I set my mind to. She never left my side when I needed her the most. Teachers that truly understood what was going on in my life, they're the ones that really make the difference in our lives as students. Even close friends helped me become the person I am today. If it wasn't for any of you, I don't know where I would be today. With that, I thank you with all my heart. And in closing reminder, I would like to give you these words from St. Francis de Sales to remember. Have patience with all the things, but chiefly have patience with yourself. Do not lose courage in considering your own imperfections, but instantly set about remembering them. Every day, begin a task anew. Thank you and good luck in all that you choose to do in your life. Congratulations.
Just to give you, when we talk about the alternative student, it's really hard for one of these students to get up here and talk in front of this group. Just a little, when you look at our students, Helen, when she came to us, was extremely shy. To get her to talk in front of 2 people was amazing. To get her to come here tonight and volunteer and talk in front of this whole audience, that's tremendous growth. And that's why we are so proud of all of our kids at Central. I have one more speech, and that's going to be from Jennifer Carpenter.
Jennifer Carpenter, and I've been a student at Farmington Central High School for about 3 years. One thing I've learned at Farmington Central was that everyone goes through hard times. It does not matter if you're rich or poor, it does not matter where you live. We've all seemed to go backwards at some point, and Farmington Central was a place where they have helped us move further in our lives. They pushed us to move forward despite our fears and our feeling of defeat. Throughout my life, I was taught the importance of family. It was impressed upon me that family comes first. Family will be with you through thick or thin. Even if you make the wrong choices, they never give up on you. My mom always has said that family does not have to be those you were born with. One of the greatest additions to my family was the staff at Farmington Central. At Farmington Central, I as well as my fellow students were brought into not just a school, but a new family. A family that at times did not agree or had pushed us in ways we did not like. Yet they stuck with us. At the end of the day, we knew we were going to be okay. We have wonderful staff here. They have helped guide us toward our goal of graduation. If it was not for them, my dream of graduation would be non-existent. There was a time that I felt hopeless, and I wanted to give up on everything. Yet with the help of the staff here, my family and friends, I am here before you today. From Operation Success to After School Help, they've got us on the road to success. For my fellow students, as well as myself, I say job well done. We have strived and gave our all to make this day happen. To all of your families and friends who have supported us throughout this quest, we say thank you. To the entire staff at Farmington Central, whether it be the principal, a teacher, a counselor, a secretary, or a janitor, your continual support has got us here today, and we say thank you. Each and every, as they say, it takes a village to raise a child. Each and every student here has been blessed to have this village to reach the success, and now as we go on, we can realize our dreams. We are class of 2012.
If you caught the theme through Jennifer, she talked about family. I'm happy, or should I say sad. Jennifer's the last one of her family. We've had two other of her siblings. I think the Carpenters liked us. So, congratulations, Carpenter family, on your third and last one through Central. Okay, Jennifer and Helen, will you join me up on stage? Graduates, would you please stand? Okay, we are now going to move your tassels from the left to the right. You are now officially grad. Graduates leave the auditorium first. We would like to invite you to a reception in the school cafeteria. Thank you and have a great evening.